And tonight, the state is seeing more grim record numbers when it comes to COVID-19. 93 more lives lost to the virus, the highest single-day reporting of deaths since the third surge in January. And during that time, we were at a hospitalization peak for that surge, according to state officials. However, this time, they say it's hard to determine if we are at that point just yet.
She had a fever, a headache, and a sore throat. And I guess the thing that went through my mind is, well, she can't get vaccinated. You just never know.
It is a big fear for parents these days. We talked to a woman whose 8-year-old daughter tested positive for COVID-19 during this frightening fourth surge, a time when we're seeing an increase in hospitalizations among pediatric COVID patients across the state.
And Gina, now as the school year is beginning here, the concern now of one parent, she says she knows she isn't the only one worried about the safety of our children. WDSU News reporter Shay O'Connor live with their story, which you'll see only on 6. Shay?
That's right, Sella and Gina. Now, Crystal says that her daughter Kennedy actually came down with COVID-19 about 3 weeks ago. Now, the 8-year-old is now out of quarantine and anxiously started school just yesterday. The mom anxious as well, knowing that what happened to her kid could essentially happen to other kids.
We pray and move forward, but there is still the concern that, you know, kids might get sick.
Crystal says just weeks ago, her 8-year-old Kennedy Bourne's tested positive for COVID-19.
She had a fever, a headache, and a sore throat. And I guess the thing that went through my mind is, well, she can't get vaccinated. What if she has to be hospitalized, you know, and she's only 8? Like, that would have terrified me.
Kennedy describing how she felt having the virus.
A little bit scared.
Thankfully, Kennedy only had mild symptoms.
She got sick, but she did not have to go to the hospital, so I was very relieved.
But now, 2 days into a new school year as a third grader, and with COVID cases and hospitalizations continuing to rise, particularly among kids, Crystal, who is also an educator, says it's all very scary.
It's hard because you can't be close. You can't. It's hard to talk through a mask, but even more than that, you're so afraid that, you know, you can be passing something or the kids can be passing something. So it's like trying to teach them and educate them, but at the same time trying to keep them all safe.
Kennedy being under the age of 12 means she can't get vaccinated just yet. Crystal saying the hope is that despite the challenges, this will be a successful school year. Still, she says she has her views starting school amid the fourth surge.
I'm surprised that we went forward instead of waiting like a week or two or even a month just so we can kind of see where it's going before we sent the kids back to school, especially with the kid numbers being so high.
Now, most schools in our state have either already started or will soon start with in-person instruction. With that being said, you can go ahead on and scan the QR code at the very top of our screen for WDSU's Back to School Guide. For now, just reporting live from downtown New Orleans, Shay O'Connor, WDSU News.
Shay, thank you so much for that. And you know, as Kennedy is on her road to recovery tonight, 14 children are hospitalized at Children's Hospital fighting for their own battles with COVID-19. 6 of the 14 are in ICU.